All right, welcome to another episode from the Chart Readers. This is actually a special one. I'm going to show you how to set up your technical indicators using the TC2000 platform. I'm going to mimic how my setup is, basically taking this thing from the line chart that you see here into having the moving averages, the MACD, the RSI, and the volume, okay? We are using TC2000. It's the system I use on every single video, and I think as I start breaking this out, you'll see why I actually do really like this system, all right? Everything here is for sure free, okay? There are some reasons to actually pay for the upgrade. I actually personally do. I did not right away because the free was more than enough as I was starting to get better, but everything here is for sure free on this system, okay? So let's get going. Look, first off, this is a very arbitrary stock. I have cats. You kind of hear them on videos every now and then, so I'm starting here. But look, this is where you go to basically look at anything, right? Tesla, Mullen. You can see these ones I've drawn lines, obviously, because I watched them on my videos, right? So Pet was really good because it reminded you guys of my kitties. And yeah, it was a naked chart, for lack of words, okay? So the first thing we're gonna do is start adding some indicators, and we're gonna go ahead and push this plus right here. You're gonna come to the first tab, which is indicators, and I mean, just look at this list, right? Again, I'm gonna go back to just saying, I am not the smartest person in the room. I do not know maybe 90% of these, right? However, the ones I know I'm really good at, I just don't care about them, right? But this gives you so many options for technical stuff, for fundamental stuff. Man, you can look at ETFs on top. Like there's a bunch of things you can do here for sure, all right? So what we're gonna do is the first one we're gonna add is the MACD, all right? Boom, you can see it's right under. The next one we're gonna add is the RSI. Boom, it's right under. And then the next one we're gonna add, which is the last one, is volume. Boom, okay. The thing that I love is not only did it add the single ones that I asked for, it automatically overlaid a moving average for you. All right, let me go ahead and tell you this. Overlaying indicators on top of indicators is next level. All right, I at one point knew what the MACD and RSI was. I did. I had no idea you can overlay something on top of that. I had no idea you could overlay something on top. You know what I'm saying? And the fact that it gives it to you automatically is fantastic if you're a beginner. And it's literally just a little taste of what you can do as you get better, okay? So I really have to call that out. Next thing I'm gonna do is actually change the colors here, okay? I'm pretty sure you go to Edit Property. Cool. Give me a second. Give me a second. Did I do this right? Color grid. Hold on. Is it these two? Hold on. I don't think that's the right place to click. Ah, here we go. You click the name, you click edit, and I'm going to change this one to green. Green is good. All right. We're going to hit OK. And then we're going to change this one, edit here, to red. Red is bad. This should look very familiar to you. And again, we're going to do the exact same thing right here. Turn this one green. Turn this one red. Again, that's what we look at, right? When green is over red, we're happy. When it's not, we're sad, right? So just like that, the three bottoms are exactly the same, right? Boom, boom, and boom. Cool. Next thing we're gonna do is start messing with this up here. So we're gonna hit, this is where we do edit chart property, sorry about that. And we're gonna come to price style. So we're gonna change the first style from line all the way to candlestick. Obviously there are a bunch of different ones. I have honestly no idea what any of the other ones are. All I care about are candlesticks, okay? We're gonna do color based on net change, all right? Red and green, obviously. Fill based on open versus close, only fill down, okay? So mimic this real quick, and then I'll very quickly show you what this means. You should see already what it does. We still have red and green, but now we have green outlined, green filled in. red filled in, red outline, okay? And again, that's because we set this up. And again, I'll show you what that means shortly, but that's a really important part of what we do for sure, okay? Now, what does it mean? So just really quickly showing you. So I'm gonna show you on Mullen. It was actually the easiest one to show you on. So look, last 3 days have definitely gone up, right? Today was obviously a nice 8% day, but today was filled in versus this one. Why? Okay, the reason is, yes, it's green, we are going up, but today someone lost some money. We actually opened up here at 15. You see when I click over there on the box, you see open 15, on the top is 13 where we close. Someone lost, I mean, almost 10%, if not a little bit more, just kind of trying to do some math in my head, right? That's not good, right? Again, yeah, we see this, but it's really important to keep in mind that this was actually a bad good day. This was a good, good day because it opens down here, goes all the way up. I love it, right? So again, we now get to see good, good days and bad, good days, as well as, let me find another one. Let's go back to pet. Oh, yeah, here's a couple one. This guy right here, again, you see it. It opens at 31 and then it closes at 28. It definitely closes under this guy. So it's red and filled. That's definitely bad and bad. This guy down here, look, it obviously goes down. It's a bad day, but it actually opens at 26 and closes at 27. Someone made some money that day. You know what I mean? So it's a really nice feature to have, and that's why we do it, okay? The last thing we're gonna do, we're actually gonna overlay the moving averages right here. So you're gonna put your mouse over this, you're gonna right click, and you're gonna add plot here, okay? I'm not clicking here and adding it lower, I wanna add it actually into it right here. And we're gonna use moving average simple. Look, there are a lot of debates about whether using moving average simple or using exponential. I very often use both. I have some charts that are set up this way, some that are that way. My phone looks one way, then this way. There are a couple different theories, and honestly, I like kind of looking at them in both. Really, it shouldn't be drastically different, in all honesty. Simple is definitely the easiest way to go. I think exponential is better when you're in a bull market, okay? A few years ago, I was only looking at exponential, honestly. Bull market, just easy, let's focus on the more recent ones. That's basically what exponential means. Simple just keeps everything even. And I think keeping everything even makes a little more sense when you're in a rougher market, you know what I mean? So we're gonna add simple, and you can see what happens. It automatically adds the 50, and we're gonna go ahead and click that and edit. We're gonna change this first one to the 8, right? I'll be honest, I think my color is green for that one. Okay, again, simple, everything else, you don't have to do anything, hit okay. And again, that's all you're gonna do. You're just gonna start repeating yourself, right? So you're gonna go add plot here, simple moving average. After the 8, what's the next one? I hope you know it before I say it, right? Dun, 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 dun. It is the 20, right? Again, we'll go orange for the 20. And then you'll see, by the way, I've been kind of staying in this third row. I think this third row is the brightest, and it just does look the best. You know what I mean? So from there, you would go ahead and just add yourself the 50, the 100, and the 200, right? I like to use red, blue, and purple, right? So I'm not gonna go ahead and finish that off, but you can already see that this chart, let's go back to pet real quick, right? Because that's actually what we started off with. This is what pet looks like now, right? And we're only a couple moving averages away from making it exact. And let's be honest, pet doesn't look that good, right? It was riding the 8 a little bit. We now see that we're under it. More than likely, we're gonna be coming down here, right? Because also we see that the RSI is kind of lowering. Check this out. If you scroll right here, you can adjust the numbers. So that's a good thing. And again, mine, you normally only see those three numbers, and it was because, again, it was the scroll, right? But yeah, this is pretty much how you set it up. I really hope you use it. I am not pretending that this is the best stack, but yeah, I really do believe this is actually one of the best sites to create your stack for sure. So have a great one. I hope you're learning.